This is a small study of that I did on a 5x7 piece of paper, and I want to now try and do a slightly larger version of this painting, because it came out pretty nice here, I think. I want to see if I can just go really bold and fast, try and keep it under an hour. See what I can do. Just take this raw sienna and start massing in the whole big shape. And I'm just gonna use this old brush. It's actually been trimmed down some because it's so old. I trimmed off the hairs or whatever. Just get the general shape. It doesn't have to be perfect and exact or anything. Well, kind of as exact as possible. But I actually just want to get the placement in here. And I think it could be a bit bigger than I started there. So bigger. It's becoming much less perfect. Just wanted to get the right size. So just go with that. And as you can see, I'm just dipping into some white. Palette out so you can see what I'm doing with that. Yes. Now this is an 8x10 canvas and that paper is 5x7, so it's a slightly different format. 5x7 is a bit longer, it's a bit squarer shape. So I guess I should keep that in mind. But it's not gonna be exact same format as that one. Could maybe add a little more on the bottom of this, or a little less over on the side, so that it fits about the same. I'll just use white with mixed in with that raw sienna. I don't know. Just want to cover the canvas. Some of these big shapes. I have to probably have the sky a bit top there. And, just some medium. Can I see that on camera up here, right? So you might see if I'm dipping into medium. But actually, I don't want too much medium in it, but a little to keep the paint flowing. And really, I want to get nice and juicy, thick paint. And this is some darks and purple. I'll just seem to want to grab that, make some darker stuff. as I'm coming back in, or finding this big stove getting a really big shape, or worrying about the colors or values even too much. Coming along, starting to form. A little ultramarine blue, maybe, just to darken that mixture of the purple and raw sienna and blue. Some dark color mixture in there. And, and some darks on here. Or refining them big shapes. Orange up here, it's like a cool cadmium orange hue that I'm trying out instead of, it's kind of a lot different than a real cadmium orange, but it's, I don't know, it's not, it's a cadmium hue. Cadmium hues of orange and a cadmium red hue. This is an actual cadmium yellow, which I haven't used that yet. But I have that available. Palette, should I want it? Oh, yeah. Darks aren't going to be as light up on top of the cow. There's a nice dark here near the these cows have white patches on them, just to make it it's, in shadow it's somewhat darker, of course. So I'll just date some of these little white patches in the shadow. Somewhat ultramarine bluey grayish color. It's gonna work okay. A little bit darker in there. Put his eye there. I'll leave that for now. Look on it. Get this little baby calf coming along together in tandem with the big cow. Why not? And in the background, with the background, some yellowish color. Green. Got a little cerulean hue in there with the cad yellow light and white. Just to start in the background in, and I'm shaping a sign of the cow. The calf goes up to there. The same brush still has all that sienna color. Just wiped it off a bit, so it's not like super clean color. And it's clean color, but yet it's, well, I don't know. Now the brush has a little bit of leftover color in it. I didn't totally have to wipe that off because it makes that yellow greenish color. It works in with that, helps that, and probably gets it harmonious looking to have the little bit of the other colors in it anyway. I might dip in the medium, just my liquid, thin down liquid, really, to helps it dry faster, and sometimes I just want to thin it down a bit so the paint flows nicely. Same time I want to, I'm getting this nice juicy thick paint on here. Not overly thick, but pretty thick. Want to get some thick paint in here because I think it looks nice and making a painting. Yeah. It's time I could start in with some of the lights on the cows. A lot of white in there. Slightly yellowish. Perhaps. Or orange. It's a yellow orange, I think. Pile a lot of white on there. I want to vary that light color. Comes a little pinker with that. Just white color. Just off white. Yeah. Oops. Let's get that whole big shape beginning to come into there. I'll wipe my brush off. It's getting gunked up. So I have it, rinsing it off and wiping my brush. That's just getting too much paint for me, I guess. I want to go a little bit bluishy, maybe ultramarine, and maybe some cerulean. A little cooler, maybe it's reflecting the sky perhaps a bit up on the top of the calf. Well, I think I'm going to come in back, begin doing the background a little bit more. We don't really need that dipping cup in the picture. Leave too much space on the palette here for me to mix on. We'll come back up to the top of that hill here. These trees are going to be considerably darker than the grass. Grabbing some ultramarine blue with the yellow and that raw sienna. Purplish, but not a little darker. Well, actually, on these a little more distant trees here, a little bit lighter. Those I'm suggesting of those. Maybe this other tree here, a little bit yellower. Here. So So the light is hitting. This is somewhat lighter. It's still a darker color than the grass. But it's light's hitting the tree. Foreground grass, more dark color, greenishy color. Sometimes it could go into something of a blue violet, maybe. The green here of valley of green to make maybe a richer green. It's emerald richy. Dark, rich green. Some stuff on here. Paint. I'm mixing with the colors I have available on the palette. Thought as long as it works. Purple in there. Anyway, so and well, let's have the whole canvas more or less evenly blocked in all the stuff. And I guess now I would might want to come in, refine these cows, both of them. And have a little black paint down there. I'll just throw that in the mix. A little dark. His eye in. That needs his eye there. Or her eye, really. Or she. It's magenta. That in the mix. And we want to cut into this background and cut into the positive shape of the cow, the background, if I need to. This guy has a really big udder. Is too light, I'm thinking, so just transition into the light to dark in there, I guess. I had burn umber on the palette before. I put that out. I may have used that burn umber in the study. I think I'll make do without it. If I even did use it there. And we can just keep using the same puddle of light color as trying to remind myself, let's keep this really simple, bold, some juicy, thick paint in there. So begin to build up this nice thick paint. I haven't really been dipping anymore. Medium necessarily. Yes, it is necessary. Well, it hasn't been necessary to me, whatever. Yeah. Probably not making too much sense. It's almost cerulean blue in here, perhaps. With I did it on the study. Greens in there into the mix. Dial out green and yellow if I want, but I could use building up some lights up on top of here, a yellow orangey color, as it were. It's light enough, right? It's light enough. I don't know. Be getting a pretty good sense of light. Doing the style of painting is kind of a lot like doing a plein air painting. Plein air. Study or whatever. So quick plein air painting where you want to get it in there as fast as possible. So you don't want to rush, but you want to just as fast as possible. And we take it some seem to be taking some of this color straight up with the, just pure color as you, from as it comes from the tube, that is. Perhaps, you know, just get some nice bright color on there and kind of mixing it into the wet paint. Yeah, I guess it's coming along. Get back to the little calf. bunch of orange in case I want more. So I'm kind of thinking I really don't have to do too much more with this, I don't think. Maybe the cows are just about, that's maybe about all I'll bother with doing on them, that I refrain from, I don't know, to do any more on them. It's already got a nice bold, brush strokey look, kind of fairly thick, juicy paint in there. I can just more or less refine the background, or just bring, just complete the background a bit, maybe. The background mostly completed. I need to do something with the sky. To dip in the medium, it's running there, and out of white. Blew right into that. To the other top of the. That's kind of sienna and white in there. Mainly from the initial blocking. Few sky holes going somewhere. Look through these trees. There's a bit in there. Gotta define the tree just a little bit. Violety bit. There's broken brush, vibrating color stuff going on. I'm gonna come a little bit lighter in here. I feel like I just messed that up. Well, don't worry. Maybe there's nothing to mess up, just... It's almost there, I just pretty much should stop around now. I'm thinking. Hey, I don't want to. I do want to just pull myself away. Be like, that's about it. Really, I just. Pretty much should be stopping any second. Just stop. Yeah, I don't think I can add too much to that by trying to make it too detailed, too ultra-realistic. I guess I'm going for this really fast style, so I'll just... I guess I'll pretty much call it a painting. I'll write my name on here with the... Scratch that in with the paint shape or color shape or whatever those that's called. And I did just put the signature in, but doesn't mean I have to totally quit. If I could just a few more brush strokes, perhaps. It's a little bit of light seems to hit here. Maybe if I would, perhaps. I quit painting already. Call it good enough, as I say. As maybe fall in the perfectionist trap of it's just never. I just want to keep going, keep refining it. But at a certain point, it's good enough, and for that matter, I'm just not doing much to improve it as a painting. I mean, probably like it just as it is. So why don't I stop around there? Kind of comparing it to the smaller one. I think I like the little one a little bit better, but not necessarily. I think I like them about the same. Okay, if I would kindly stop painting, I think that's it. Orangey. Slightly deeper color. Lighten grass and just, would I please stop? Because, okay, well, I think that's it. So these are the two versions of this painting, and I think the larger one matches up. I like it as much as the smaller one. It lives up to the smaller one or whatever. They're not exactly the same. Have spontaneous little differences, and I think I like them both. So thanks for watching, and bye bye for now.